so how's everybody today? And so today it is Wednesday, December 28th, and yes, I got my new shirt. It is this a pizza Mickey Mouse shirt that I got from Disney, and it is at the new, the Uniqlo store that is at Disney. And so yes, and this shirt is actually a very good price for the Disney standards, and it's a really good price. And this year when we went on vacation, so we discovered a new store, and we love the Uniqlo store. Love, love, love. So, today for dinner, it's a weird dinner. It's like a microwave dinner thing. And I got these, quesadillas from Walmart, which I really like. It's my new favorite. And also, I got a breakfast for dinner sort of idea. It's this, breakfast sandwich. And it is a new stuff at the store. It is this, Jimmy Dean stuff. It has sausage, egg, and cheese muffin sandwich. And I first saw somebody at work get it, and I was so excited to see that. And because I do not like the breakfast menu items from McDonald's, and that reminds me of the McDonald's, and so I really wanted to try it. I am so hungry today, guys. Excuse me. Oh. And, so I really, really wanted to try it, and that's why I decided to buy it. So how are you guys doing today? How are you guys doing with all the Boxing Day shopping, the Boxing Week shopping, whatever the heck shopping they call it these days? I'm doing okay. Hanging on there. So I guess for today, this mukbang video would be the last mukbang video. It's like my Happy New Year to you guys video for the mukbang. If I do not do any more mukbang. So Happy New Year to you guys, and hope your 2017 would be fabulous. Or if your 2016 is going fabulous for you already, hope it will be even more fabulous for you. Woo! This quesadilla got a better kick than last time.
Yeah, they got a kick on them.
Last time was like a mere so-so, but this one actually has like peppers and stuff in it. But the only thing I do not like about this product is, like, look at this one, guys. Like, by the time you open the package, the tortilla wrap is all broken and shattered. Like, look at that. I did not steal any bites to this tortilla. The wrapper, it's broken. I think it's like the way they package them or something. I really, really love this pizza Mickey Mouse shirt. I really do. It's so funny. Like, when we went to the Uniqlo store the first time, it was like right there at the front table. And it was like screaming my name. It's like, Kelvin, buy me, buy me. And I was, of course, thinking of you guys, and I'm like, whoa, this would be not, this would be wonderful for my mukbang shows. Wow, this tortilla product, it's got a good kick to it. Like, you do not need to add any extra ketchup or anything to this. Was Mr. Matthew busy at work today?
It was dead this morning, but then it picked up a little bit.
Oh. OMG, guys. My day, it went so fast. The 8 hours, it's like nonstop the whole day for me. Ooh la la! Did they mail out new coupons?
Yes.
They say there is no artificial flavors. Blah 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 peel.
Whoops. Peel, not rip.
Like, over the years, though, the McDonald's, the bakery stuff, they have improved so much. Like, these are actually really, really delicious. Like, especially, like, those chocolate croissants and stuff like that. Oh. Is this one of their more useless ones that they just send all breakfast? Oh, no. Okay. It's just really annoying though. They provide more breakfast coupons than actual the meal coupons. Oh, and also an update from the Harvey's video, the one that I ate had the stuffed cheeseburger. And so I said that they mailed out a coupon that expired on Christmas Day, and so right now they sent out another coupon. Now they sent out some updated ones, and this time the Harvey's, they actually have a coupon that I actually like, which is the buffalo chicken burger one. So we'd be going there soon, hopefully. Woo! It's got a spicy kick, doesn't it, Matthew?
Am I hearing you whining?
So this is what the breakfast sandwich looks like. And is the Jimmy Dean like sort of like an American brand of stuff? Because I do remember seeing the Jimmy Dean stuff on the commercials, and I always put ketchup in my McMuffins, my egg muffins, whatever you call them.
Not a McMuffin, because it's not from McDonald's.
Oh, sorry. It's just whatever I'm used to calling it. Wow. These egg muffins are actually really soft. They taste like they're just fresh, but
really?
It only just took like not even a minute in the microwave for the hard work cooking. Wow. I am impressed by this for like a frozen product. Wow. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. It's not chicken.
I don't call it a winner.
Like for a frozen product, the egg, the muffin. What do you call those? Those are muffin sandwich. It's really, really
English
soft. This is definitely a winner, guys. You guys will be definitely seeing more of this. This is like sort of like a different, like a breakfast for dinner idea, right, Matthew? Oops. And the egg is like really fresh to it. It feels very fresh. I don't know the word for it. You know what? I think that this kicks McDonald's butt. Like, I would rather grab this than the McDonald's one any day. These guys, they also have a bacon one, Matthew. They have a bacon and a sausage one. Does the Jimmy Dean sell other frozen stuff too? Because I swear I've seen other commercials for that stuff. Yes, yeah. It's a really hearty breakfast too, hey? Matthew? That was some really good stuff there, guys. I'm starting to get full. Hiccup show. Oh, and I cooked these fries in the deep fryer today, and they actually cooked out just fine this time. Oh, and I want to make mention something. It's like one of the TV channels that we have here, which is on a free preview. It's like one of the cooking channels, whatever it's called. And I saw one of the commercial clips for it, and then I heard a familiar voice in the commercial, and I looked up. I'm like, what? I'm like, the Laura Vitale got an actual TV program on the TV network now. Like, if you do not know the Laura Vitale, she is like one of the bigger, like the cooking channels. I was like, wow. Like, she is one of the ones that actually made it. She went from YouTube and she actually got her own TV show on the TV network. I was actually pretty amazed by that. Like, on her YouTube, her YouTube channel is called The Laura in the Kitchen. And so today I had to take the bus home today from work. It's actually not too cold out. The weather on the information of the Calgary Transit, because they have these signs that shows the messages and stuff and the weather and stuff everywhere in the stations. And they say the weather today was only just -2. And when I went outside of work today, it actually felt colder than that. I don't know what the heck is with that. But the weather today was only just -2. Which is not bad. And also, all our Christmas food is basically done, besides the pies. We still have the pies left over. Having some coffee. I actually got some of these little crackers here. These are really delicious crackers. This one is like a Canadian, it's a Canadian brand of crackers. It's like the Raincoast Crisps. This is the what? The cranberry one? Making some crunch.
Three different ones in
making
there.
Some crunchy noises for you guys.
Cranberry and hazelnut, salted dates and almonds, and rosemary and raisin pecan. You're gonna have to guess which one's which.
The one that is actually not as good as I thought it would be is that in the Halloween time, the fall, they come up with this pumpkin harvest one. That one is not really a pumpkin spice taste that I was looking for. It's basically, it's like the pumpkin seeds they put in this crackers. It's not really what I was looking for, so I do not like their fall time flavor that they got. Mm. I am in the mood for munchies. Delicious. These are the macarons that I got from Costco, and these are actually meant for Christmas dinner, but we actually forgot to bring them out. So, these are actually made in Paris, France. Hope you guys can see that. So these are actually made in France. So these are as genuine traditional macarons as you can get. And it is the flavors. They have chocolate, vanilla, raspberry, pistachio, and hazelnut. And of course, my favorite flavor is the pistachio, because that is the flavor that I fell in love with when we went to Paris last time. And how do we open this? Open it. Can you let me try the pistachio one first, please? I want to get sugar high today. So, I don't know, because right now I just finished a cup of coffee with dinner. And what is the traditional thing to drink with macarons? Is it like supposed to drink like wine or something? Okay, can I show the people the tray, please?
No, because the tray is going to fall apart. Careful.
So the tray, it comes like this, and it's like a flappy open. So which direction was the thing from? Which one is the hazelnut one? Or, oh.
Okay, chocolate, vanilla, raspberry, pistachio, hazelnut.
Macarons. Oh, and so a little bit of a story time here. So when we went to Paris, there was this restaurant, and they offered the dessert, and they offered it either this small, they had a small tiny ones, or they have the big ass huge ones. And so, of course, I got the huge one. So, if you want to go look for it, don't forget to check out my Paris vacation playlist. And it's under the food section. Under the food section, okay? The macarons. Mmm. Because in my opinion, when you have the original, the French from France, the macarons, you cannot have the other types from elsewhere. You have to have the original ones.
That doesn't taste like what we had out there. The ones I made from scratch tasted more like the original from France.
What was the red one again?
Raspberry.
Raspberry.
Actually, I'm just reading the ingredients. These aren't made properly. They're not made properly.
Hey, but these are made in France, though.
Yeah, I know. They must have done a different recipe. Oh, that one's better. Maybe it was just the hazelnut one. That one's better.
Already starting to get a bit of the sugar high, the sugar kick.
Because that one was normal. That one won't taste the way it should have.
Chocolate.
So far, they all taste the same. It's kind of upsetting.
Mmm.
Oh, that one I can taste the raspberry.
Mm-hmm.
Because on average in the normal bakeries in Calgary, they usually sell the macarons like this size. It's like almost like $3 each, almost. Hazelnut.
Okay, so far the raspberry one's been the best.
I actually do not taste much of the hazelnut. I think it is like the shell of the macaron that is overpowering the hazelnut. I really do not taste much of the hazelnut.
I didn't taste much in the hazelnut or the pistachio. The raspberry was good. The vanilla.
The chocolate is really good, though. I can taste the chocolate because if you mess up on the chocolate flavor, there's going to be something wrong with you if you mess up on chocolate. Like this video if you agree with that comment. Guys, can I have one more of each flavor?
God, that's a lot, Calvin.
Whee! I'm gonna go sugar high! Yeah!
That's a weird chocolate in that one. It's a weird chocolate in that one.
Hmm.
I was hoping the hazelnut and the pistachio would be the best ones.
The but does this product have to be kept cold?
Yes.
So actually, in this set, the one that disappointed me the most is the hazelnut. And the best one is actually the chocolate one. Mm-hmm. It's a red color giving me red tongue.
Out of those, the best flavors and raspberry and vanilla.
One of the new stores that opened near us, they have a little macaron section too, but they're like one of the stingy attitude types, and then they're like, oh, it's not available all the flavors every day, and we do not know what flavor is available every day, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, can I order certain flavors? They're like, oh, it's not guaranteed every day what flavors they make, blah, 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 blah. It's like, whatever, to heck with that attitude, just whatever. Remember that when we went there? That's what the girl said.
I'm trying to remember. Excuse me. You're going after more? Oh my God.
Horsey!
Kate, you're cut off. I think everybody on your channel agrees.
I'm a little bit disappointed by this. I really wanted this to be good. The ones that we had at the restaurant in Paris was better than these ones. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I was actually really looking forward to these because this has been sitting in our fridge for a while. I'm a little bit let down by this now, guys. Alright, guys, and so thank you so much for tuning in today to some dessert with me today, guys. And so welcome to my new subscribers, and don't forget I got a Mukbang video playlist, and I got a playlist of all my other older videos, and I'll see you guys again soon.